Paramahamsa Nityananda is a rare living incarnation, a yogi by birth. He has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English, books in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian and Chinese, with translations in 26 languages are available. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 8,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services, ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world offer exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. Having meditation centers in 151 countries including Bidadi, Thiruvannamalai, Rajapalayam, Salem, Hyderabad, Varanasi, Los Angeles, Ohio, Seattle, San Jose and Phoenix. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, a spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation. A contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers. Adept in Ashtamaha Siddhis, mystical yogic powers, he has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands, gracing them with spiritual powers. A spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples worldwide in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places like Bangalore, Hyderabad and Thiruvannamalai in India. A dynamic young guru who is an inspiration to thousands of youngsters. India's most watched spiritual guru online. A beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
Nityanandaya swagatam, nityamuktam nirvikalpam, dhyana loka pradipakam, vande shantamayam bandham, nityanandaya swagatam, ananda gandha sancharam, sarvopadhi vinirmuktam, vande jnanalayam natham, nityanandaya swagatam.
सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां. I welcome you all with my love and respects. Let's enter into Bhagavad Gita. Today's subject, in Arjuna Vishada Yoga, first chapter, 11th verse. Ayaneshu cha sarveshu yata bhagam avastitah bhishmame vabhi rakshantu bhavanta sarva evahi. Now Duryodhana is speaking not only to Drona, to the whole group. Ayaneshu cha sarveshu yata bhagam avastitah भीष्ममेवाभि रक्षन्तु भवन्तः सर्व एव हि. stationed in your respective divisions on all fronts, all of you must give full protection to Bhishma. Duryodhana knew that the only factor that could save him will be protecting the Bhishma. Only Bhishma can protect Duryodhana. So he is telling the whole Gaurava army, exhorting them to support their commander-in-chief Bhishma. Bhishma, let me introduce this unique character. See, Mahabharata is a book where the personification of each quality appears as one character. Please understand, in your life, so many different experiences you go through, so many different parts you carry in your brain. See, one part of your brain is knowledge. One part of your brain is compassion. One part of your brain is violence. One part of your brain is cunningness. One part of your brain is speed with discrimination. One part of your brain is speed without discrimination. One part of your brain is the pure silence. If all these parts are awakened, you are full bloomed, then you are Krishna. Understand, when the each part of your brain is actualized to its complete potentiality, it is self-actualization. If all parts, all the non-mechanical parts of your brain is actualized to its full potentiality, it is called self-realization. So each part, non-mechanical part of your brain, actualized in full form, becomes one character in Mahabharata. Giving is one dimension, non-mechanical part of your brain. When that has actualized its full potentiality, when it has reached its peak expression, that character is Karana. Cunningness, that is also part of your brain. A non-mechanical part of your brain. When that reaches its full actualization, that is Sahuni. Knowledge, the education, when that reaches its full actualization, Drona. So each character is an actualization of certain non-mechanical part of your brain. Bhishma is the actualization of respecting social conditioning, social norms, adjusting your life as per the social requirements. This is also one part of your brain. Constantly, all your ambitions, all your desires, all your goals, all your ideals, all your ideas are edited, altered, organized as per the society's expectation about you. Society gives certain requirement list to you. You tend to alter all your ideas, ideals, goals as per those requirements. Sometime when you are not ready to alter, when it is too much, you rebel. You become a revolutionary. Here, Bhishma is the personification of ability to alter your personal ideals and ideas, ambitions to the requirement of society. I am not saying it is right. Please understand. I am not saying it is right. And I am not saying it is wrong. This is also one dimension of your non-mechanical parts of the brain. In your brain, there is a non-mechanical part which goes on altering, changing, correcting, editing. Your ideas and ideals as per the requirement of the external society. People who are benefited by your adjusting, by your alteration, by your acceptance, they call you as a Tyagi.
Discover the secrets of health and wealth in one package. For the first time, a two-day health and wealth workshop by Paramahamsa Nityananda. Healing for a range of ailments. Wipe out illness from body, mind and being. Awaken your body's natural intelligence and healing powers. Overcome stress and powerfully resolve your wealth-related conflicts. Discover the secrets of creating and celebrating wealth.
Let me tell you step by step how you build the patterns. First, the memory. Morning, 7 o'clock, coffee is very nice. After 1 month, it becomes samskara, engram. Morning, 7 o'clock, I should have coffee. After 1 year, it becomes muscle memory. Means morning 7 o'clock, if I don't get coffee, I will feel little low mood. I'll feel low, feel little irritated.
Dynamic interactive awareness sessions that reveal the secrets of a perfect health and having abundance in wealth.
I will have headache. That is bio memory. After 6-7 years or 10 years, really one day you are caught somewhere, you are not able to get coffee and having headache, rolling on the ground, that is DNA level. Now understand how the memory becomes samskara, engram, engram becomes pattern, pattern becomes muscle memory becomes bio memory becomes DNA level pattern.
Intense meditations and kriyas that holistically instill a transformed health and wealth consciousness in you. At Baroda, from March 24th to March 25th, 2012. Contact 91 851 11 5239.
But I am not saying it is 100% right. Bhishma is embodiment of social conditioning. He has become such a character, he does not even have a pain when he alters his requirements as per the need of the society. When he alters his necessity as per the need to the society, I should introduce Bhishma to all of you. He is really an enchanting character. For some people, he can be unimaginable hero. For some people, he can be just a person who has given up everything. I can say, except achieving the enlightenment, yes, all the auspicious things. Instead of taking that jump from social conditioning to enlightenment, at the last moments of life, he took the jump in the last moments, in the deathbed. If he has taken that jump a little early, I can say he would have been one more Krishna. A second perfect expression in Mahabharata. Maybe he sacrificed even his enlightenment to maintain a unique character representing social conditioning. He represents social conditioning. Whatever is expected from you socially. Dedication to parents, dedication to the country, dedication to the king, dedication till the end to all the rules and regulations of the war, even while the opposite, the enemies are breaking all the rules and regulations. First time, Krishna is breaking the rule, commitment he made. He will not take up a weapon and fight. He has picked up a wheel, chariot wheel, and trying to kill Bhishma. Bhishma says, "Oh God, if you want to kill me, come on, I am here." He drops all the weapons. And he says, "You are a charioteer as on now, in your position. A charioteer is not supposed to take up a weapon and fight, especially when the owner is alive and active. But if a charioteer wants to fight, I am ready. I am ready to accept." And even in the end, nobody was able to defeat him. Nobody was able to defeat him. He made a vow, he will not fight with transgenders. He will fight only with men. So, very cunningly, sorry to use the word, but that is the right word. Very cunningly, Krishna brings Shikhandi to the front, war front. When Bhishma sees Sikandi, he knows if he does not fight with Sikandi, he stops sending the arrows, he will be killed. Arjuna is hiding behind Sikandi and sending the arrows. All the arrows attacking Bhishma are from Arjuna. Because in those days, in each arrow, the name of the person will be engraved. So each arrow touches him. Bhishma sees it is Arjuna's arrows. Means Sikandi is only in the front. Arjuna is hiding. But he did not even bother. I have taken a vow. I will not fight with transgenders. I will fight only with men. And he stands by the vow, even while dying. I can tell you, such a personification of vrata, the will, whatever society teaches you as good, if you collect all those qualities, Bhishma is the embodiment of all those qualities. Nobody else can be such a perfect expression of social conditioning. Only from the angle of enlightenment, I should say, Bhishma is a little late. Other than that, from any angle, if you look at him, he is personification of perfection. Just because he missed that one point, I am not able to say he is personification of perfection in everything.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapitam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.
Except that one point, I can say he is equivalent to Krishna in everything. In every dimension, you should know his character completely. Here is a guy, young, energetic, supposed to be a next king. Bhishma's father is a king. Santanu. His name is Santanu. Bhishma was supposed to be the next king. He's already a prince. Suddenly one day, father comes back. That guy is a womanizer. Comes back very depressed, dejected. Bhishma asks, father, what happened? You are the king of all the three worlds. What is the reason for your dejection, depression? Shantanu says, no, I went for hunting. I was hunted and still haunted by a beautiful girl I saw near the forest. Bhishma says, what is the problem? Marry her, bring her to the palace, let her be your queen. Shantanu says, no. She made a condition. Knowing that I am a womanizer, I may not take care of her kids. She wanted me to promise that her children only will be the next king. He says, I don't want that to happen because I already promised to your mother. He had an affair with Ganga, and please understand, when I say Ganga, don't think the Ganga who is in the Shiva's head. The tributary, each river energy was assumed as a feminine god, a tributary to Ganges. One more water energy, that is what is meant by the word Ganga. Don't think the Ganges, which is in the Shiva's head. So when Ganga gave birth to 8 children, the story says she started killing each one. The moment she gives birth, she will kill them. She will throw them in the water and kill them. She has taken the vow from Santanu that if any time Santanu questions any of her actions, she will leave him. But Santanu was not able to tolerate. 7 of his children were killed. The moment 8th one took birth, Santanu goes and says, please at least spare this one. The moment Santanu questioned, Ganga says, all right, I'll spare this child for you, but as per my condition, now I'll leave you because you questioned my actions. Santanu asks, tell me, you are such a wonderful woman. Why did you kill your own children?